If you want to express yourself with your photography, then it's time for you to learn how to make selections. Selections will take you to a different level than everyone else. And it will help you express your thousand words to the world. So let's get to it. This channel is the home of the Macro Photography Live Chat Show and a place where I answer macro and landscape photographer questions. This question is a question that was given to me by Matthew. He is actually part of our membership program. And this is just a teeny little segment that I'm going to share with you on making selections. We're going to talk about the marquee selections that will really enhance what you could do with your photography. The first one that I want to talk about is the rectangle marquee tool. And all you'll do is just take an area from your image that you want to select and you want to do something with, and then you will take the mouse and you will drag it across that area, and it will make a rectangular marquee. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get into the rectangular marquee tool. You can use the M shortcut key to open it up. What you'll do is you'll drag, I'm going to get on that layer, and then I'm going to drag with my mouse and just make a selection. I'll have my feather at 1 pixel. And there we go. And you'll see what a difference it is between 1 pixels and many pixels. But let's show you the pixel one. Once I do that, I'm just going to click delete and it will show below the image below. And you can see that there is a, let me do command D for deselect. So then I don't get those marching ants. And now you'll be able to see that the selection is very sharp and has a straight 1 pixel cut or selection. Next, we'll change the feather so you can see what it looks like. You know, you may want a softer feel to your selection. So let's go ahead and make this 25 pixels. And I'll drag my mouse again. And we will make a selection. I'll go ahead and, now that I have my selection, I'll go ahead and tap on the delete, and you can see how soft this selection is now. And you may need that, so always pay attention to your feathering.
If you want a square, then you hold your shift key, push down and hold that mouse and drag with the shift key held, and then release the mouse, and you will have a perfect square selection. The next key that's really important is the elliptical marquee, and that's kind of like an oval type shape, so you can have more of a round feel to the selection.
Click on the marquee section and we'll get to the elliptical marquee selection. So here you go. You've got your section and you want to move it around, you can.
If you want a complete circle, a perfect circle, then just hold that shift key and drag, and again you will have a perfect circle. Very useful when you need something that has the sides more of a roundish feeling to it. Now, especially when you're working with the circle or elliptical, make sure that anti-alias is checked at the very top. That will give you a soft feel on the curves. It takes the pixels that are around it and then it adds color to it, so you don't have a jagged edge. So that is perfect for you if you're going to make that type of selection.
So right now we're in rectangular. And you can see that this anti-alias right here is not available for you. And the reason why is that it really does help for elliptical or circle marquee. If you have it off, you may have a jagged edge on the side, but the anti-alias, what that does is it will take the selection and it will smooth it out by using the variety of pixels within the area and filling in more color to make it nice and soft. I will talk about this selection and mask area right here, but that's going to be in a different week.
On that top bar, there's also different ways that you can use your selection tools. You can manually just drag whatever you want. You can correlate width and height through pixels, and you could also use ratios. So if you want to cut or have a certain ratio amount and want to select, then you can do that also. So play with those top tools too, because it will make a difference in your selection tool that you're using. These selection tools really will make a difference in your photography work, because you will take a portion of your image, select it, and whether you want to add to it more exposure, you could do whatever you want on a layer, you can cut things. It has an endless possibility when it comes to those specific tools when you want to select an area in your photograph.
All right, so now let's use these selections in real life. Why would we even need these? Well, most of the time, I personally love to use the selection tool to fix things that I need fixing. I use them in landscape to make things perfectly symmetrical if I need to, like a horizon or a home that's in there, or whatever that is distracting my eye that should be straight, I will select it and I will maneuver it. You guys in the membership have gotten how to fix flower petals. Well, I love to make selections and fix my flowers and other goodies to make them the way I want them to be. So let's just go ahead and do that right now. So I will take this elliptical marquee tool, and I have it on normal, and I'm going to actually feather it just a little bit, say about 10, not 100, oops, 10, and let me get this going here, move it. I actually need to make a second layer. So it stays, it doesn't matter, it just keeps it going until you're ready. So I have a second layer, and then I always love to right click on my selection, and I could deselect, do all these fun things here. Most of the time what I'm doing is a layer via copy. That's what I usually do. And you can see over here to the right that I have a copy of what I've done. I just selected that and now I'm going to play with this. So what I want to do is, you can see this layer selected, and now what I could do is actually really maneuver this by playing with it. So I'll go ahead and Control for PC, Command for Mac, T to transform. That's the shortcut key. It's so much easier. Just do it that way. Now I can move it around, you can see, but I actually want to keep it in the same spot, and I can maneuver it to make it, say, look a little straighter. Say I want the flower to be a little bit straighter. We'll go ahead and just mess with it. You can see that it's kind of funky down here. So it may not work. So what can I do next? I'll do a Command Z to go back. And then I say to myself, okay, let's go ahead and warp it. and see if that will work. So then warping can really change things up. So I see, whoa, that's a little bit too much. If anything goes crazy, just do the Command Z and that will just fix things of what you've done before. So now I'll just go ahead and manipulate this flower a little bit and get it to the way I feel like it would just look good in my eyes. And then you can see that before and after. See, it's done a little bit of stuff in here, and I would clean that up with a mask. And I'll just show that to you now because why not, right? I'm going to clean that up, make sure it's black, paint with black, and I will remove some of what I've done. Let's see, my flow is only 4%, that's why it's not working. Woo! You can see that's hitting some of the flowers. So let me push X. Hold on 1 second. My laptop's going. I'm doing everything on this on the laptop, you guys. Before and after. And that's how I would actually use these selection tools.
Again, this is a teeny little part of a mini course that the members are getting in the membership program. Have questions on anything? Ask me down below, and if you're new to the channel, subscribe. It's a lot of fun. We are yet fun and serious at the same time, making some beautiful work to tell your thousand words. Cheers, everyone.
Hey, are you ready to focus on your dream of photographing with a purpose? Is it finally time for you to make a difference in our world with your thousand words? Sweet, we can help. Get started and register for SJP membership program at sullivanjphotography.com/SJP membership program. Set your goals and complete them.